breaking down, crying. For us. For me. For me. The Lamb was slain. Praise me, the Lord. Amen. I praise him. Amen. Amen. Good music. Good words. Well, today we have something very exciting. It's always wonderful to invite our missionaries to speak here at Bible Presbyterian Church. It's wonderful to have somebody from South America who's actually going to be speaking to us in Spanish, but it's going to be translated by his nephew. And his nephew, Jaime, is a student down at Pensacola Christian College. And I must tell Keith Coleman, one of the things I've discovered about Jaime this week is he loves lemon cake. And so I have some lemon cake to send home with you when you take these gentlemen. Actually, I'm joking. He's had a piece of lemon cake that he ate one bite out of, and I have served it to him over and over again. And he's going to eat it, right? Just kidding, just kidding. No, it's been a blessing. We've had them for 13 days. Today's number 13. And it is a joy. We've gone to eat at many different restaurants. We've gone to eat at many different times in our kitchen and over at the manse. We've had a lot of fun together. Very good time this week. And they've been a good help during summer Bible school. We're thankful that you allowed them to be with us for these 2 weeks. And thank you so much. And gentlemen, it's been a pleasure to have you with us. And now we are going to, without further ado, hear Jonathan. I'm told that in Chile, in South America, he always preaches for at least 2 hours, and so we have translation. So, you know, make yourself comfortable. We'll be here for the next 4 hours. Jonathan.
En primer lugar, queremos dar gracias al Señor por la invitación que ustedes nos han hecho.
First of all, I want to thank for the invitation to come to this church in New Jersey.
Y las gracias al Señor también por el Pastor Christian Spencer.
And I'm really thankful for Pastor Christian Spencer.
Que no aguantó varios días.
Because he was trying to stay with us this whole time, and
tuvo mucha paciencia.
He had a lot of patience with us.
Estamos muy contentos de estar acá, pero también es un poco difícil hablar en español y después traducir en inglés. Entonces esta es la segunda vez que lo vamos a hacer.
It's a little bit hard to speak in Spanish and then be translated in English. And this is the second time that we're going to do it, so I hope you understand.
Vamos a buscar en Mateo.
Let's open up our Bibles in Matthew.
Capítulo 28, versículo 18 al 20.
Chapter 28, verse 18 through 20. Matthew chapter 28, verse 18 through 20.
Dice así la palabra del Señor. Y llegando Jesús les habló diciendo, toda potestad me es dada en el cielo y en la tierra. Por tanto, id y adoctrinar a todos los gentiles, bautizándolos en el nombre del Padre y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, enseñándoles que guarden todas las cosas que os he mandado. He aquí yo estoy con vosotros todos los días hasta el fin del mundo. Amén.
And Jesus came and spoke unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen.
Conocemos este pasaje como la Gran Comisión.
We know this passage as the Grand Commission.
Estas son las últimas palabras de Jesús. Él da instrucción para todos.
These are the last words of Jesus giving instructions to everybody.
¿Qué es un misionero?
But what is a missionary?
Los misioneros no son una clase especial de cristiano.
missionaries are not an special group of Christians or an special class of Christians.
O son más cristianos que otros.
Or are more consecrated or Christians than others.
O son cristianos raros.
Or they are not weird Christians.
Los misioneros son aquellos que obedecen la palabra de Dios.
Missionaries are the ones who obey the word of God.
Todos podemos ser misioneros.
Everybody can be a missionary.
Es muy importante que llevemos el evangelio a todas partes.
It's really important to share the gospel with everybody in anywhere.
A veces no necesita ir a otro lugar porque en su propia casa puede ser un misionero.
Sometimes you don't even need to go to another place to be a missionary. You can be a missionary in your own city.
Yeah. Recuerdo que cuando empezamos la obra en Temuco,
I remember when we start a church in Temuco, Chile.
Yeah. Iban 4 pastores, incluyéndome a mí.
We had 4 pastors going to that church, including me.
Pastor Nadir Carreño.
Pastor Nadir Carreño.
Pastor Baudilio Saavedra.
Pastor Baudilio Saavedra.
Y Pastor Jim Fosse.
And Pastor Jim Fosse.
A veces yo tenía que viajar 2 o 3 veces al mes.
Sometimes I was used to go 2 or 3 times a month to this city.
Muchas veces hacía mucho frío.
A lot of times it was really cold.
Lo hice por 8 años.
Raining, but I did that for 8 years.
Viajaba de Chillán a Temuco, son aproximadamente 5 horas en bus.
I was used to go from Chillán to Temuco, and it's around 5 hours drive in a bus.
Yeah. La necesidad era tremenda en Temuco. Empezamos en una casa.
But they had a lot of needs in Temuco, so we started the church in a home, in a
yeah.
house.
Visitábamos mucho alrededor de la casa.
We start visiting the places around that house.
Después en otros lugares.
And then we start moving to another places.
Después se fue formando la iglesia.
And then we start starting this church.
Actualmente hay una iglesia.
Now there is a church in there.
También empezamos una obra más o menos a 23 kilómetros de Temuco.
We also start another church 23 kilometers far away from the city of Temuco.
Yeah. El lugar se llama Huichahue.
The place is called Huichahue.
Por lo general todas las personas que viven allí o vivían en ese tiempo eran campesinos.
Generally all the people who lives in that place are people who works the land.
Yeah. Había mucha necesidad.
There was a lot of needs there.
Algunos no querían venir porque eran extremadamente católicos.
Some people didn't want to come to church because they were Catholics.
Recuerdo que a veces yo repartía un tratado o algunos tratados y algunas personas no querían recibir el tratado, entonces iban retrocediendo.
I remember that sometimes I went to give tracts in the streets of the city, but the people didn't want to receive the tract.
Yeah. Pero después se formó otra iglesia.
But then we opened another church.
Yeah. Después empezamos una obra en Cabrero.
And we started a church in Cabrero.
Pastor Baudilio Saavedra.
With Pastor Baudilio Saavedra.
A 60 kilómetros de Chillán.
60 kilometers far away from Chillán.
Íbamos casi todos los domingos.
We were used to go every Sunday.
Es difícil empezar una obra nueva porque hay que tener mucha perseverancia.
It's really hard to open a new church because you have to be really perseverant.
También mantener una obra es difícil porque tiene que estar continuamente trabajando en ese lugar.
And to have a church is really difficult also, because you have to be in that place and you have to have a lot of time.
Yeah. Pero también un misionero no es tan solo la persona que está evangelizando en la ciudad.
But a missionary is not just the person that is evangelizing in the city.
Puede ir a otro país.
You can go to another country.
Marco 16:15.
Let's go to Mark 16:15. Chapter 16, verse 15.
Dice así. ¿Escuchaste? Y él les dijo, ir por todo el mundo y predicar el evangelio a toda criatura.
And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Ya. Yo cuando era joven estaba recordando que algunas veces vine de Filadelfia y del seminario de fe.
When I was young, I was just remember that I was coming to Philadelphia to the seminary of faith.
Vine a esta iglesia.
And I came to this church.
Algunas veces.
Sometimes.
Pero siempre me sentaba atrás.
But I was used to sit in the back of the church.
Después que estuve aquí en Estados Unidos.
After I was here in the United States.
Regresé a Chile.
I went to Chile.
Me casé.
I got married.
A los 40 años.
When I was 40 years old.
Y a veces me preguntaba si sería bueno que me casara o no.
And after that I was used to ask myself, is it good to be married or not?
Pero al final me decidí.
And finally I took the decision to get married.
Ya estaba un poco viejo.
I was a little bit old.
Ya. Me casé con Janet.
I got married to Janet.
Ella es 13 años más joven que mí.
But she is 13 years younger than me.
Y le pregunté a ella si era bueno que los casáramos. ¿Qué pensaba ella?
And I asked her, are you sure you want to marry me?
Ella dijo, pero ya tenemos edad.
But she said, we are already old.
Entonces nos casamos.
And so we got married.
Sentí, cuando estuve aquí, fui a Guatemala.
When I was here, after I was here, I went to Guatemala.
Era soltero.
I was single.
El doctor Leroy.
Dr. Leroy.
Me pasó dinero para que fuera a Guatemala.
Gave me some money to go to Guatemala.
Y fui y estuve aproximadamente un mes.
So I went there for a month.
Pero después que regresé a Chile,
but after I went back to Chile,
hubo una reunión del presbiterio en una ciudad que se llama Molina.
There was a meeting with the presbyterium in a city called Molina.
Yeah. Y preguntaron quién podía ir a Guatemala.
And they asked, who wants to go to Guatemala?
Nadie quería ir.
Nobody wanted to go.
Un pastor dijo que en Guatemala habían serpientes y habían caníbales.
One pastor said in Guatemala there are a lot of snakes and people that eat each other, so you don't want to go there.
Yo me reí porque había estado ya.
I started laughing because in an opportunity I went to Guatemala before.
Fuimos con mi esposa a Guatemala.
So I went with my wife to Guatemala.
Llegamos allá y la recuerdo siempre que la primera vez repartimos 1,000 tratados.
And the first time we got there, we gave 1,000 tracts.
No llegó nadie.
Nobody came to church.
Continuamos trabajando.
We start working on there.
Poco a poco algunas personas se acercaron a la iglesia.
But some people start coming to church after a while.
Recuerdo siempre una hermana que se llamaba Blanca Sosa.
I always remember a sister called Blanca Sosa.
La visité varias veces.
I visited her a couple times.
Algunos dijeron, nunca va a venir.
Some people said, she's never going to come to church.
Pero un día vino.
But one day she came to church.
Y recibió a Cristo como su Salvador personal.
And she received Christ as her personal Savior.
Algunas personas también, algunos adolescentes, recibieron a Cristo como su Salvador.
Some young people received Christ as their personal Savior also.
Pero habían pasado 2 años y medio.
But after 2 years and a half, 2 and a half years,
había crecido la iglesia muy poco.
The church was growing just a little bit.
Pero un día llegaron 28 personas.
But one day 28 people came to church.
Venían de otra iglesia.
They were coming from another church.
Eran muy especiales porque todos trabajaban en la obra.
They were really special because they were really hard workers.
Ellos ayudaron mucho a la obra del Señor en Guatemala.
They started helping our church a lot.
Y la iglesia fue creciendo.
And the church started growing.
Después se empezó a construir un templo con una capacidad para 300 personas.
Then we started building a church for 300 people.
Allá en Guatemala nació Ruth May Lee.
In Guatemala, Ruth May Lee was born.
Yeah. Habían pasado algunos años.
And after a couple of years,
y ya estábamos listos para salir de Guatemala.
We were ready to leave Guatemala.
Cuando el doctor Leroy, Dr. Guay, nos escribió si queríamos pertenecer a la junta.
When Dr. Leroy wrote us a letter if we wanted to be a part of the mission, independent board mission.
Yo le dije que sí.
And I said yes.
Ya. Vinimos acá, estuvimos casi un año en Estados Unidos.
So we came to the United States and we were here for a year.
Recuerdo que Ruth May Lee, cuando tenía 1 año y medio, vinimos a esta iglesia.
I remember Ruth May Lee when she was 1 year old, we came to this church.
Corría por los pasillos.
She was running around.
Yo tenía que ir a la siga.
I was trying to follow her, but she was running away.
Jonathan Edward tenía 6 meses.
Jonathan Edward was 6 months old.
Había nacido acá.
He was born here.
Pero siempre sentimos la necesidad de llevar el evangelio a otras personas.
But we always feel the necessity to take the gospel to another people.
Por esa razón es que recordamos que siempre las personas tienen problemas terrenales y problemas espirituales.
But we know that people have two big problems. Problems here on earth, I mean problems at work, and spiritual problems.
Por eso tenemos que evangelizar.
That's why we have to evangelize.
Cada vez nos encontramos con un mundo más tenebroso y más oscuro.
Every day, every time, when we find this world that is getting darker and darker.
Porque se acerca la venida del Señor.
Because God is coming soon.
Nosotros vemos que la familia está siendo destruida.
We see some families that are being destroyed.
Si viniera Cristo en 2 o 3 días más,
if Jesus come in 2 or 3 more days,
¿cómo consagraríamos nuestras vidas al Señor?
How would you consecrate your life to Jesus Christ?
Tu vida al Señor. ¿Cómo evangelizaríamos?
How would you evangelize?
Voy a citar algunos versículos nomás.
I'll give some verses, Bible verses.
1 Corintios 15:51-53.
1 Corintios 15:51-53.
Una de las razones por qué los jóvenes no tienen madurez suficiente hoy día.
One of the reasons why young people is not mature.
Porque están siendo atacados de varias formas.
It's because they are being attacked in different ways.
Estamos en una patria enemiga.
We are in an enemy soul.
Eso es lo que dice Juan 17:15.
That's what John 17:15 says.
Pero nosotros sabemos que pertenecemos a una ciudad celestial.
But we are not, we know that we are part of a holy land, of a holy city.
Hebreo 11.
Hebrews 11 says so.
Hoy día la amistad mundana influye más que la cristiana.
The worldly people has a lot of influence in us more than the Christian people.
Los valores del mundo, no hay nada tan bueno ni nada tan malo.
The values of the world said there's nothing too good and there's nothing too bad.
Por esta razón necesitamos llevar el evangelio.
That's why we need to take the gospel to every person.
Romanos 1:16.
Romans 1:16.
El mundo es un tremendo enemigo.
The world is a huge enemy.
Nunca dará la verdadera felicidad.
Never is going to give true happiness.
Solo Cristo hay salvación, gozo y paz.
Just in Christ you can find salvation and peace.
Mi familia, tenemos tres hijos.
In my family we have three children.
Ruth Meili es la mayor.
Ruth Meili is the oldest one.
Siempre le decimos que ayude en la escuela dominical.
We always tell her help for the church.
También toca el piano.
But she also plays the piano.
Jonathan Edward ayuda con los juveniles.
He helps with the youth ministry.
Pero le gusta mucho jugar el fútbol.
But she loves to play soccer.
Melissa también toca el violín de vez en cuando.
She also plays the violin sometimes.
Pero necesitamos que toda la familia,
but we need the whole family,
para ayudar en la iglesia y para evangelizar.
Involved in the church to evangelize and to help.
Cada día oramos para ganar otros para Cristo.
Every day we pray to reach more people for Christ.
Necesitamos preparar a otras personas para que lleguen el evangelio de Cristo.
We need to prepare more people so that they can take the gospel of Christ.
Si una iglesia no evangeliza,
if a church doesn't evangelize,
cada vez va a perder más personas.
It's gonna start losing people.
Dale de riso. Esa es la razón por qué es muy importante llevar el evangelio.
That's the reason why it's really important to take the gospel and share with the gospel with other people.
Mi familia está trabajando en Arica.
My family is working in Arica.
Alguna semana salimos a repartir tratado.
Sometimes we go and give tracts to the people.
Janet va buscando niños todos los domingos.
Janet goes every Sunday to pick up some children.
Los niños tienen mucha necesidad. Son niños.
Children have a lot of necessity.
Cada domingo le damos desayuno.
We give them every Sunday breakfast, every Sunday morning.
Pero también entregamos el plan de salvación.
But we also get the chance to give them the gospel.
Nuestro propósito ahora,
our purpose now,
es alcanzar a los padres,
is to reach their parents,
porque necesitan a Cristo como su Salvador.
Because they need Christ as their personal Savior.
Los hogares que tienen estos niños,
those homes,
es difícil para estos niños porque algunos de sus padres son viciosos al alcohol, la droga, etc.
These homes, it's really hard to evangelize these homes because they have issues with alcohol, drugs, and things like that.
Pero algunos padres han llegado.
But some parents have come to church.
Pero necesitamos más. más evangelizar.
But we need to start evangelizing more.
Damos gracias al Señor.
Really, we are really thankful to the Lord.
Por la oportunidad que nos da de estar en Arica.
For the opportunity to be in Arica.
Y damos gracias a ustedes.
We are really thankful
por su apoyo en las oraciones.
For your support in prayers.
Y soporte económico.
And the economic support.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you so much. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for the opportunity to be here. My Lord, I pray that you can bless this church. I pray that you can bless these people. Give us the burn in our hearts to be able to get more souls for Christ and to go and preach your gospel, give tracts, and so that we can grow. I pray, Lord, that you can give us the wisdom, the knowledge that we need to be able to do this, but we know that we can do all things through you, Lord. So give us the strength, bless us through the rest of the day, and the honor and the glory be to you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Gracias.